Hi, I'm Michael. I work at for Digit. Before I worked for Digit, I was a digital nomad. I'm going to tell you something about a nomad. I'm talking about digital nomad, van life, and my own experience. So, what is a nomad? I think most people know what a nomad is, but just briefly, it's a people that are going from place to place for their animals, and they don't have a living area, permanent residence. So, a digital nomad, the only thing that they have in common is that they don't have a residential area. A digital nomad uses the digital skills to work online remotely and uses that skills to travel the world because, remote jobs, you can work from everywhere where you have internet. So one way of doing that is van life. Van life people are living in a van, but it's not only vans. You can also be in a bus, a camper, or a truck. Van life is something that is very popular in America. Most of the time, it's not because they like it, but because it's the only option they have. So that's a little bit sad. But in the last few years, it becomes very popular with younger generations because younger generations want to try travel the world. So they combined van life with a digital nomad to travel the world for 3 years. So that is something that I did for 3.5 years. For a half year, I lived in Vancouver, Canada. When I came back to Europe, I built my van and I traveled to Europe. For some time, only the first year was pleasurable because then COVID hits, a lot of restrictions, a lot of things were closed. Police didn't like that I was moving a lot, so not the best time. I built my van in like 1 month, 2 months, working on it full time. I had some few requirements. It needs to be an automatic because I like to drive easy. I don't want to change everything. Like everything in the bus needs to be ready to go. I don't want to every morning wake up my bed or put my bed away. It needs to be all fixed. And it has to have enough power because sometimes you need to work all day, so you need to have enough power for that. So I found this, it's the inside, you saw all the pictures, and the orange PostNL van is it was cheaper because no company wants an orange van, and I can find it easily if and I park it somewhere. So it's a win-win. So the bus was equipped with 600 watts of solar power on the roof. For most of the times, it was enough power, but in some cases, like when I was in up to Norway, then in the end of autumn, it was not enough. It also had a connection to the car engine, so. In that case, if you are driving, it will charge the battery. In the case of Norway, I have to run the engine for an hour to fill up the battery again to work. So this was the end result after all the work, after 1.5 months. It had a toilet on the left seat, under this left seat, and you can convert the between the seats and then the shower. And in the back, under the bed was enough room for extra storage. It could even fit my mountain bike, and I've got a pretty big bike because of my height. So this lifestyle had made it possible for me to stay and work at very beautiful locations, but not always. Most of the time, you're always standing on a supermarket park or somewhere in the street, especially when you're near cities, because in cities, there's not a lot of nice places to stay. So, if you like, I would suggest take a look at it and maybe try it. It's really fun. Maybe when the COVID is, I hope that the COVID is over because COVID sucks in a fun life. So, any questions? You asked what I do with the bus now. I've sold the bus because I didn't know what to do with it, and I saw all the gas prices, and I think that in a few years everything going to be electric, and I'm like, what do I can now, and last year and this year the prices of campers were really high, so I was like, I'm just going to sell it, and if I want to do it again, I will just build a new one, but then fully electric.
Yeah,
Other questions?
No, I guess that's it. All right.